In this session, we will discuss about the cultivation technology of specialty mushrooms. And specialty mushroom is a term given to group of mushrooms which are less common in particular area of country. For example, in our case, button mushroom is a common mushroom, and everybody knows about the button mushroom. But as far as shiitake is concerned, very few people know about the shiitake. That's why in case of Japan, they are cultivating lot of shiitake, and for them shiitake is a common mushroom, but for them button mushroom is a specialty mushroom because it is less known in Japan. And as far as specialty mushrooms are concerned, first one is Lentinula adors, that is shiitake mushroom. The Japanese wood mushroom, commonly called as shiitake, is most popular mushroom in Japan, and it is second largest mushroom cultivated in the world. And unique taste, flavor, and presence of chemical reduced plasma cholesterol level in the blood. And presently, there are about 14,000 mushroom species. Of these, about 7,000 species are considered to possess varying degree of edibility. Almost 3,000 species are of prime edible nature, and about 300 species possesses medicinal properties. And these are some of the medicinal properties of mushroom which are commonly used in Chinese traditional and herbal drugs. For example, Agaricus bisporus, that is white button mushroom. It is known to stimulate digestion and curing hypertension. Then Arucularia polytrica, that is black ear mushroom, known to strengthen health, helping blood circulation. Boletus edulis, causing muscles and joints to relax. Then Corylus versicolor, known as turkey tail, curing chronic diseases. Then Ganoderma lucidum, that is known as Rishi. It is known to rejuvenate body and neurasthenia. Then Gryphola frondosa, that is Metake, strengthening health and resisting diseases. Then Heracium adnaceus, that is monkey head mushroom, known to beneficial to heart, kidneys, liver, lungs, and spleen. Now these are some of the notable medicinal mushrooms. One first one is Reishi mushroom, that is Ganoderma lucidum. Second one is caterpillar mushroom, that is Cordyceps sinensis. And third one is Metake mushroom, that is Gryphola frondosa. And of course, shiitake, just we were discussing shiitake mushroom, that is Lentinula adults. And black ear mushroom, Arucularia species. And winter mushroom, that is Flavinella velutivus. And we will discuss about the cultivation technology of these mushrooms. Now coming to shiitake. As per a share of shiitake production in different countries are concerned, here Taiwan is number one mushroom, shiitake mushroom producing country with 33% share, and followed by Korea and China. Now, as far as medicinal properties of shiitake is concerned, it has anti-tumor polysaccharides activity and glycoprotein, antiviral nucleic acids, platelets aggregation inhibitive substances, anti-cholesterol active substances. And medicinal properties, lentinan isolated from shiitake mushroom is an approved drug in Japan. And lentinan is a polysaccharide found in shiitake, has been shown to be responsible for many of its beneficial effects. Although an injectable form of lentinan is used in some countries as an adjuvant to cancer chemotherapy, definitive data on shiitake's efficacy as an oral anti-cancer agents are lacking. And shiitake also contains 8 essential amino acids in better proportions than soybeans, meat, milk, eggs, as well as a good blend of vitamins and minerals, including vitamins A, B, B12, C, D, and niacin. These are some of the milestones in shiitake cultivation. For example, spontaneous slow cultivation in nature. Discoverer was Wu Sheng Kang in the China, around about 1100. Pure culture span and low cultivation. it was in Japan. Then pure culture technique, it was also starting in Japan. And presently, sawdust substrate that has been initiated in Europe, and it is of recent origin. Now, temperature requirements for cultivation of shiitake, for example, spore germination, it requires 15 to 25 degrees centigrade, and optimal temperature range is 22 to 26 degrees centigrade. The mycelial growth 5 to 32 degrees centigrade, and for optimum temperature for mycelial growth is 24 to 27, and fruiting 5 to 25, 15 plus minus 2, that is strain dependent. It means that we have different strains which can fruit at different temperatures. For example, some may strain at 10 to 15 degrees centigrade, some strains will fruit at 15 to 20 degree centigrade. Some strains will fruit at 20 to 25 degree centigrade, but not more than 25 degree centigrade. No shiitake will go on fruiting beyond 25 degree centigrade. That means you have to select the strain depending upon your climatic conditions and other requirements. Now, as far as cultivation technology of this mushroom is concerned, generally two methods are followed. One is cultivation on wood logs, and second one is cultivation on synthetic logs. First, we will discuss about the trees suitable for wood log cultivation, that is tuna, mango, hornbeam, oak, she, birch, and maple. These are trees suitable for, means those trees which have broad leaves are suitable for the cultivation of shiitake mushroom. As far as steps involved in the cultivation of these mushrooms are concerned, first one is log preparation, second one is span preparation, third one is spanning the logs, and fourth one is crop management. Logs with 9 to 8 centimeter dia and 15 to 20 years old trees are selected for log cultivation, and the time for cutting trees, not cutting tree but lopping the branches, is December, January. And logs should contain moisture content of 44 to 55%, and if moisture content is less than 20%, there will be no mycelial growth, and pH of the log should be 4.5 to 5.5. Now, as far as spanning process is concerned, small holes of 1 into 1 centimeter and 1.5 to 2 centimeter deep are made on the logs. Holes are made at a distance of 20 to 30 centimeters and 6 centimeters between each row. And the holes between two rows are alternate in positions. Sawdust span or boot plug span is inserted by cutting out small size pieces, or even wheat grain span can be used for the spanning boot logs. After spanning, the holes are sealed with paraffin bags. And keep the inoculated logs in open place where physical conditions are most favorable for the mycelial growth. Keep inoculated logs in a plate pile or minimum light exposure. Cover the pile with straw or gunny bags, and vegetative growth in the logs will complete in 8 to 12 months. It means it will take around about 1 year for colonization of wood log by mycelium of shiitake mushroom. For fruit body induction, shock of temperature drop, high humidity, and enough light is required. And for fruiting, either spray cold water or immerse logs in tank of cold water during summer and 2 to 3 days during winter month, that is at 15 degrees centigrade. Lean after giving this cold treatment, after putting in the cold water, lean the logs against some support. Maintain high RH, that means 80 to 85%, and temperature should be 15 to 20 degrees centigrade. And mushrooms are harvested up to 3 times, and rest for 3 to 4 days are given. And after that, water to get again the mushrooms. It can be repeated 3 to 4 times per year. And logs will produce crop to up to 4 to 6 years. Means once you span the logs, you can get shiitake mushroom up to 6 years. These are the some of the slides depicting the process of shiitake cultivation. Here one can see first one is cutting the logs, then making pieces of the logs, then drilling up logs at a proper distance, 15 to 20 centimeter or 3 to 4 centimeter at alternate positions. Then spanning the logs either with the wood plug span or sawdust span or wheat grain span, and then sealing it with parafilm webs. Here see the position of logs kept in some shady place. Either you make a heap or put in some leaning positions. And after 1 year, he is giving shock treatment by hammering the logs. And after 10 to 12 days of giving cold shock treatment or hammering, you will get the shiitake mushrooms on the logs. This is the composition of a sawdust span. For example, here we take sawdust 78%, then wheat bran 20%, sucrose 1%, calcium carbonate 1%, and water content should be 65%. Then you can also prepare span on wood plugs, wood chips. And here you can see the wood plug span. Small chips are made that can be inserted into the drilled holes for the cultivation of shiitake. And wood logs inoculated, and here can you see the staking. It is covered with some polythene sheet or some gunny base or some straw. It must be clean, and direct sunlight on the logs should be avoided. And after giving cold treatment or cold shock treatment or after hammering, then fruit body initiation will be started, and after some times you will get the shiitake mushroom on the wood logs. And after harvesting, give the rest of 25 to 30 days, then again give the cold shock treatment. Then after giving cold shock treatment, you will get shiitake mushroom after 10 to 15 days of giving shock treatment. And by this method, one can continue harvest shiitake up to 6 years. Now, there is scarcity of wood and no one will permit to cut the logs. Here we have used some alternate to logs, that is bag cultivation. Cultivation technology is very simple. First one is substrate selection. Substrate means you have to take the sawdust of broadleaf trees. For example, mango, tuni, hornbeach, birch. You will take this sawdust, then filling of bags, bag filling is done and sterilization. Then after cooling, spanning the bags, and after span and cold shock treatment, and then bags are kept for fruiting. Here are some of the cultivation processes which are generally followed in cultivation of shiitake. First one is autoclaving, then inoculation, then incubation, bag opening, and then fruiting. These processes are given in detail in next slide. This is a technology for short duration fruiting in shiitake. Here, generally shiitake takes 80 to 90 days per span term, and after 120 days, you will get small peanuts on the synthetic blocks. But by using this technology, one can get shiitake fruit bodies within 45 to 47 days. Here, cultivation is carried out on sawdust of selected trees. That is, sawdust is taken, 100 kg sawdust is taken. Then 20 kg wheat bran is added, and then calcium carbonate 1% and calcium sulfate 0.5% is added. First of all, we have to wet the sawdust thoroughly, and after wetting sawdust thoroughly, then wheat bran, calcium carbonate and calcium sulfate are added, and then after thoroughly mixing, substrates are filled in polypropylene bags, that is PP bags, 1.2 to 1.5 kg wet substrate per bag. Then bags are sliced in an autoclave at 22 pounds PSI for 90 minutes. After sterilization and cooling of bags, grain span is inoculated at the rate of 3% wet waste basis on the top of top. And bags are incubated at 4 hours, 20 hours, light dark cycles at 22 to 25 degrees centigrade. And span done will be completed in 36 to 40 days. And During that period also, one can get the bump formation and browning of these synthetic blocks. After bump formation, then cold shock treatment is given by putting some water in a tub and adding some ice so that what temperature of water can be brought down to 6 to 8 degrees centigrade. And these blocks after bump formation are immersed in the water for 10 to 15 minutes after removing the PP bags. And after giving cold shock treatments, these bags, these blocks are kept in the cropping room at 22 degrees centigrade at RH of 80 to 90%, and light is given for 4 to 5 hours. And after 2 to 3 days of giving cold treatment, small primordia, that means small mushrooms, will develop, which will mature into full grown fruit body in next 3 to 4 days. And why this method? On spawning only once, you can get fruit bodies of this shiitake up to 6 to 8 months. Here, these are the some of the process. This is wetting of sawdust. Sawdust is wetted thoroughly. Then checking the moisture content by simply pressing the wetted sawdust. If some water droplets ooze out from the sawdust, then it means the moisture content is more than 65%. And if moisture content is 64 to 65%, then more water droplets should ooze out. Then mixing of wheat bran 20%, calcium carbonate 1%, and calcium sulfate 0.5%. And these these ingredients are mixed thoroughly. And after thoroughly mixing, these are filled in PP bag, that is polypropylene bag, at the rate of 1.5 to 2 kg per bag. And one thing should be kept in mind, that sawdust should be filled in the bags by pressing the sawdust so that a compact block can be made. Here you can see that 1.5 to 2 kg substrate per bag is being filled. And after filling the bags, just insert the PP neck in the mouth of the bag and plug it with non-absorbent cotton. And after filling the bags, just autoclave it at 121 degree centigrade for 1.5 to 2 hours. This is how these synthetic blocks are autoclaved. This is autoclaved bag, and inoculation is being done in second slide. And third slide, here you can see the spawn is kept on the top only, and it will automatically colonize the substrate by downward growth of the mushroom mycelium. There are some strains which can be grown on the wheat straw also, and process is same, same amount of wheat bran and calcium carbonate and calcium surface is added. Then it is also autoclaved, then spawned. Here you can see the commercial activity, truckloads of this synthetic blocks are shifted to cropping unit. Here you can see the top one, the spawn run is on sawdust substrate, and second one is on wheat straw substrate. And first slide shows that spawn run is complete. And in second slide, here you can see the bump formation is there, some bumps are there. Only at this stage, we have to give the cold shock treatment. If before this bump formation stage, someone gives the cold treatment, then this block will be of no use. It will get broken. But after this bump formation, simply remove the PP bag, polypropylene bags, put some water in a tub, add ice so that temperature could be brought down to 6 to 8 degrees centigrade, and dip these blocks for 10 to 15 minutes in water. And after dipping, simply shift in cropping room at a temperature of 20 to 22 degrees centigrade with RH of 80 to 85%. And after removing PP bag, after coming in contact with the air, the bags will turn brown. That is known as cold hardening phase. Here you can see the treated blocks are kept in a cropping room, and small pinheads are coming from the blocks. And after 2 to 3 days, this will further grow up. And one thing should be kept in mind that these fruiting in these shiitake stems are temperature dependent. Here you can see the one stand that is OE3888. That stand is selected for this 45 days cropping. And one can get bumper crop in first harvest, and up to 8 months one can harvest shiitake like this. This is another stand. Here you can see the fruit bodies are thick and color is also brown. Then this is another stand of shiitake. Fruit body is very thick. And this is the comparison between wood logs and synthetic log cultivation. Here, in case of this natural logs, it will take 11 to 12 months per spawn, whereas in synthetic logs, it will take 80 to 100 days. Whereas in present synthetic log technology, it will take 45 to 47 days. And production period in natural logs, it is 3 to 8 years, synthetic logs, 8 months. And present synthetic log, that is 45 days cultivation technology, it will take 6 months. The production, natural logs, one can get 10 to 15 kg per 100 kg of log. In case of synthetic log, it is 80 to 100. But in case of synthetic, present synthetic, it is 110 to 130 kgs. And as far as management is concerned, it is very difficult in case of natural logs, easy in synthetic logs, and very easy in present synthetic logs. Here you can see the heavy fruit body of shiitake, thick fruit body of shiitake. This is the crop of shiitake in the cropping room. Here you can see the 4 different strands of shiitake. And cultivation of these strands depends upon the prevailing climatic conditions of the your era. If one goes for the seasonal cultivation, but if one cultivator is in high-tech units, then one can select the strain depending upon his requirements. Here you can see the fruit body is ready to harvest. This is another strain of shiitake ready to harvest. This is another strain. This is flower shiitake. We are getting this shiitake in Delhi INA market from some other countries. As far as culture of this strain is concerned, we don't have this culture of this mushroom at DMR. And here you can see the packaging and grading. Our uniform size is there, and fruit bodies are packed nicely. Then one can go for bag cultivation. Also, if there is less space, then one can hang the shiitake blocks. This is another shiitake cultivation hanging method. These are some of the abnormalities. If you spray direct water on the shiitake, and after that, if no fresh air is introduced, then bacterial growth will be there, and it will spoil the fruit bodies. Then this is faulty autoclaving. If autoclaving is not proper, then green mold is bound to come. Then if there is no hygiene and sanitation measures adopted in the unit, then the slugs will attack the shiitake and they will feed on the shiitake mushrooms. And these are the fresh and dry shiitake for marketing. If there is lot of production, then one can go for drying of the shiitake and packaging. And if fresh market is available, then one can go for fresh sale of shiitake mushrooms. This is the minimum size of economically viable unit for shiitake cultivation. This is just a hypothetical or tentative estimate. For example, production facility with 6 cropping rooms, which are of the size of 10 into 14 to 10. Then number of bags can be accommodated 10,000. And number of cycles in a year, there will be 2 cycles, and expected yield from 2 cycles, that is 20,000 bags, that is 130 quintals per annum. This is simple farm layout for the shiitake with three growing rooms, with cold storage, incubation rooms, and other facilities. This is the production cycle, say during January, or it will be fruiting, then spawned. Means one lot will be in spawning stage and one lot will be in fruiting stage. Then coming to Pianoderma, that is Rishi mushroom, and Lingzhu and Lingzhi mushroom. It is known as mushroom of immortality in China and Korea. It is highly medicinal mushroom, and this mushroom grows almost all around the world with over 250 species, and this mushroom also grows on sawdust of broadleaf trees in summer and summer. And production, as far as production status is concerned, definite figures for Ganoderma production was difficult to obtain. In Japan, in 1995, the production was 500 metric tons. That was dry. Global production is about 6,000 metric ton, and whereas estimated global turnover of Ganoderma product is about $2.5 billion. As far as India is concerned, the trade of Rishi mushroom is to the tune of approximately ₹15 million, and is expected to increase manifold in days to come. These medicinal mushrooms, mushroom capsules and tablets are imported from China, Malaysia, Thailand, Australia, USA, UK, and other countries. More and more research is now being undertaken in all the mushroom R&D organizations in India, and pilot projects are in operation for preparation of these medicinal mushrooms in collaboration with pharmaceutical companies. As far as medicinal properties are concerned, it has anti-tumor, immunomodulating, cardiovascular, respiratory, anti-hepatotoxic, and anti-neoceptive effects. Traditionally, it has been used widely in the treatment of hepatopathy, chronic hepatitis, nephritis, hypertension, arthritis, insomnia, bronchitis, asthma, and gastric ulcers. It reduces blood pressure, blood cholesterol, and blood sugar level, as well as inhibition of platelet aggregation. Now, medically active biocompounds, bioactive molecules that are polysaccharides, that is function is immunomodulatory, anti-cancer, hepatoprotective, hypoglycemic, anti-histamine release, anti-angiogenic, then terpentines, anti-tumor, anti-HIV, immunomodulatory, cardioactive, hypotensive, hypolipidemic, then amino acids, anti-hypertension, and anti-hepatitis B. Adenosine and derivatives, immunomodulatory, then organic geranium, that is anti-tumor property. Cultivation technology or method of cultivation technology is same, and substrate used for cultivation of this Ganoderma mushroom is also same. Only thing is that in case of Ganoderma, we don't give cold shock treatment, and temperature required for its fruiting is 30 to 35 degrees centigrade. So all these tests will be same for substrate preparation, except for growth or fruiting. That is, in case of shiitake, it is 22 to 24 degrees centigrade. But in this case, in case of Ganoderma, it is 30 to 35 degrees centigrade. Otherwise, rest of steps are same. Technology cultivation is carried out on sawdust of selected trees, same method. Then mixed substrate is filled in polypropylene bags. Bags are sterilized in autoclave. Grain spawn is inoculated at the rate of 3%. Then bags are incubated at 23 to 25 degrees centigrade. And spawn run will be completed in 36 to 40 days. A room temperature of 30 to 35 with RH of 85 to 90% with a light of 10 to 12 hours are maintained for the fruiting of this Ganoderma mushroom. Here you can see the Ganoderma cropping. Here we are using this boiler for increasing temperature, because in our case temperature never goes beyond the 28 degrees centigrade during summers also. Here we have used this boiler to increase the temperature and relative humidity. This is the pinning in case of this Ganoderma mushroom, which will turn into mature fruit bodies within 5 to 6 days. Here you can see the fruiting in case of this Ganoderma mushroom. And this is another species of Ganoderma mushroom, very lustrous and red in color. These are the, some of the products which are in, being imported in India. That is Ganoderma coffee, Ganoderma tea, some capsules are also there. And there are lot of products which are made up out of the Ganoderma. And this is the minimum size for economically viable unit for Rishi cultivation. That is production facility of 3 cropping rooms in the size of, with the size of 10 into 14 to 10. And number of bags can, that can be accumulated per room is 5,000. Cycle to be completed in a year, that is 4. And expected yield from 4 cycle, that is 6,400 kg fresh and 2,880 kg dry. This is the production center, room 1, room 2 and room 3. One can decide the production cycle depending upon the demand and his requirement also. Here I am stopping with these 2 mushrooms. If time permits, we will discuss about this Pleuritis rangei and some other mushroom in next lecture. Now we will discuss about the cultivation technology of specialty mushrooms. Now, specialty mushroom is a term given to group of mushrooms which are less common in particular area or country. Now, coming to some of the specialty mushroom, first one is Pleuritis rangei. It is also known as Kabul dhingri. And Pleuritis rangei has recently become the most commonly cultivated mushroom in East Asia. Other names used to refer to this mushroom include French horn and King Trumpet Royal. Sometimes it is also called as the Boletus of the steppes, King Trumpet mushroom, or Trumpet Royal. It is commercially grown in Japan, South Korea, Italy, Australia, South Africa, and the US. It ranks 3rd in amounts of total mushroom produced in the world. This mushroom has antioxidants, and the antioxidant in this mushroom comes in the form of an amino acid known as ergothionine. And this mushroom also carries statins, which are disease-fighting compounds. And the particle compound found in this mushroom is called as lovastatin. It is a compound that helps to clear cholesterol. And this mushroom is also an excellent source of energy booster and has an antibacterial properties also. The cultivation technology is very simple. For cultivation of this mushroom, either we can use sawdust, weed straw, paddy straw, supplemented with organic nitrogen materials such as wheat bran, rice bran, and other nitrogen sources. And here in this case, substrate is wetted thoroughly in water for 16 to 18 hours. The process is same as we have discussed about the cultivation technology of the shiitake. Now, after wetting, 20% wheat bran is added in the substrate and mixed thoroughly. Here you can see the, here we are using the sawdust substrate, and it is supplemented with wheat bran 20%. Sometimes we add calcium carbonate 1% and 0.5% to this calcium sulfate. This is the addition of wheat bran in the wetted substrate. Now, in this case also, generally we fill 1.5 to 2 kg substrate per bag. Generally we use the PP bag, polypropylene bags, which are heat resistant. And bag should be filled tightly by pressing with the hands. 2 kg or 1.5 or 2 kg wet substrate is filled in each polypropylene bag. with the size 18 into 16 inch. The bags are plugged with non-absorbent cotton by inserting polypropylene ring at the mouth of the bag. The filled bags are then sterilized in an autoclave for 1.5 hours at 22 pounds PSI. That is 121 degrees centigrade for 1.5 hours. After the sterilization, the bags are cooled down to up to 18 to 20 degrees centigrade, or you can say in a room temperature, up to room temperature. And they are inoculated with wheat grain based spawn that at the rate of 3% on dry bed basis. Generally, 30 to 35 gram spawn is used per bag, and spawn is kept on the surface only. Inoculated bags are incubated at 20 to 25 degrees centigrade, and spawn run will be completed in 15 to 20 days. After the completion of spawn run, PP bag is removed, and blocks are then placed in the cropping room at a temperature of 10 to 15 degrees centigrade with a RHO of relative humidity of 80 to 85%. Now, fresh air is provided for 25 to 30 minutes daily for optimum development of the fruit bodies. And pin heads will start developing after 5 to 7 days after removing the bags, and mature fruit bodies are harvested 3 to 4 days after pinning. Here you can see the spawn run is taking place, and just like shiitake, spawn is kept on the upper layer of this substrate, and it will ultimately colonize the whole block by downward movement of the mushroom mycelium. This is the crop of king oyster, that is Kabul dhingri, on wheat straw substrate. Fruit bodies are very thick. Either this can be cultivated, these mushrooms can be cultivated in bottles or plastic containers also. Here you can see the very thick and heavy fruit bodies are coming all over the bag. This is vertical cultivation by using single container. And in this case, we will get only single fruit body per container, which will be very thick and heavy. This is the fruit body of this king oyster. Here we have tried this containers, bottle type containers for cultivation of this king oyster. And here you can see the single fruit body is coming from single container, and fruit body is very heavy and thick. But this method of cultivation is very much labor intensive. And here you can see the single fruit body is coming on the plastic container. Now, another specialty mushroom, that is Aurocularia polytrica. It is also known as black ear mushroom or wood ear mushroom. And this mushroom has the oldest record of cultivation by Chinese dating back to 600 AD. And it is commercially cultivated in some of the Southeast Asian countries. And this mushroom ranks fourth among all the cultivated edible mushrooms. And this mushroom is believed to cure sore throat, anemia, certain digestive disorders, especially piles on regular consumption. And in India, this mushroom is collected and consumed in northeastern states. Cultivation technology is very simple. For cultivation of this black ear mushroom, generally we take fresh wheat straw of good quality, which is soaked in water for 16 to 18 hours. And after that, excessive water is drained out. And one thing should be kept in mind, that moisture content of the substrate should not be more than 65%. And after wetting and draining out the excess water, add 5% wheat bran on wet-to-wet basis on the soaked wheat straw. And generally we fill 2 kg substrate in each polypropylene bag, and it is also autoclaved at 22 psi pressure for 1 to 1.5 hours. And on cooling, spawning is done at the rate of 2% dry bed basis. Generally, For the cultivation of all the specialty mushrooms, we need an autoclave, we need a laminar airflow, and this autoclave, laminar airflow, and good BOD incubator also. This is the wetting of wheat straw in water for 16 to 18 hours, and then filling in the bags up to 2 kg per bags. And this is the stage of spawning. That means mycelial colonization of the wheat straw. And after spawning, incubate the spawn bags at 25 to 26 degrees centigrade. And spawn will be completed in 20 to 25 days. On completion of spawn, give coarse cut to gives or slits and hang these bags for putting at 25 to 26 degrees centigrade, say up to 27 degrees centigrade, and maintain high relative humidity of 80 to 85% by spraying water once or twice on the bags and in the room. Give diffuse light and aeration for 1 to 2 hours daily, and fruit bodies will emerge after 10 to 12 days after giving the cross cuts and will mature for harvesting in next 4 to 5 days. Harvest mature fruit bodies which can be consumed fresh or can be sun-dried. Here you can see the crop of this black ear mushroom, and generally we get 60 to 65% biological efficiency in this case. Fruit bodies are leathery in texture and can be easily sun-dried for later uses. Then next specialty mushroom is Heracium erinaceus, that is monkey head mushroom, also known as loin's mane, and it is a very rare mushroom and declared in the red list of endangered species in various European countries. And it contains a number of polysaccharides such as beta-glucan, heteroglucones, heterozylans, as several cyanothane derivatives, terpentines known as hericinone and erinacine, which are neurotrophins such as nerve growth factors. And it is a choice edible when young, and the texture of this cooked mushroom is often compared to seafood. And this mushroom is rich in some physiologically important components such as beta-glucan polysaccharides, which are responsible for anti-cancer, immunomodulating, hypolipidemic, antioxidant, and neuroprotective activities. And it has also been reported to have antimicrobial, antihypertensive, anti-diabetic properties. Cultivation is very simple. For all the specialty mushroom, method of substrate preparation is almost same by using autoclave, filling 1.5 to 2 kg per bag, then autoclaving, then spawning. Only difference is the temperature requirement for the fruiting. For every mushroom, for spawn run, it needs a temperature of 24 to 25 degrees centigrade. But as you put for fruiting, then temperature varies. For example, this king oyster, it requires a temperature of 10 to 15 degrees centigrade for fruiting, and in case of this Aurularia, it was up to 27 degrees centigrade, 25 to 27, and here in this case it is 18 to 20 degrees centigrade. Of course, for spawn run, temperature requirement is 24 to 25 degrees centigrade. The cultivation technology is concerned, this mushroom can be grown on wheat straw, sawdust, sugarcane bagasse, cotton seed hulls, or chopped paddy straw. Similarly, wet the substrate thoroughly, add 20% breed bran, fill 2 kg substrate in polypropylene bags, and bags are plugged with non-absorbent cotton by inserting a ring on the mouth of the bag. Autoclave the substrate at 22 psi for 1 to 2 hours, and after cooling of the bags, add spawn at the rate of 3% on wet basis, and then incubate bags at 23 to 25 degrees centigrade for 20 to 25 days. That means it will take up to 25 days for spawn run and the optimum temperature for fructification is between 18 to 20 degrees centigrade. And fruiting will start after 7 to 10 days of bag opening, or either you can make holes all around the bag, some very small hole, so that fruit bodies will grow through the holes. And harvest mature fruit bodies and mushroom can be consumed fresh or sun-dried. Once you spawn these bags, you can harvest mushroom up to 6 to 8 months, and they will start giving fruiting up to 6 months. This is the monkey head mushroom on wheat straw substrate. Nice fruit bodies are growing. This is growing on sawdust substrate. Here you can see the good crop of this monkey head mushroom is coming. And this mushroom also requires light for 4 to 5 hours. Then next mushroom is Phlemurina velutips, that is winter mushroom. And it is an important mushroom and ranks 5th in terms of global mushroom production. It occurs naturally on willows, poplar, elms, plum, maple and beech trees. And this mushroom is also known as Enoki, golden needle mushroom, velvet fruit or velvet stem. And it was first cultivated in China during 8th century. And as far as proximate analysis is concerned, it contains 31.2% protein, 5.8% fat, 3.3% fiber and 7.6% ash with certain bioactive molecules. As far as magical attributes are concerned, it is rich in peroxidases, superoxidase, dismutase that can prevent some severe diseases like cancer and coronary heart disease. And this mushroom contains compounds that prevents as well as cure liver disease and gastroenteritic ulcers, provided it is taken on a regular basis. This mushroom contains immunomodulatory anti-tumor and antibiotic substances, and it also contains several types of amino acids, including valine, which inhibits the growth of Ehrlich, SCTs, tumor, and sarcosome in mice. Cultivation technology of this winter mushroom is very simple. Generally, we use wheat straw or sawdust for cultivation of this mushroom. This mushroom is one of the wood decaying fungi like oyster mushroom. Here, sawdust is wetted thoroughly with water for 16 to 18 hours, just like the shiitake. After wetting, 5% wheat bran is added in the sawdust, whereas in case of shiitake, we were adding 20% wheat bran. And then after adding the wheat bran, 2 kg substrate is filled in polypropylene bags. And bags are plugged with non-absorbent cotton by inserting a ring on the mouth of the bag. And the filled bags are sterilized in autoclave at 22 lbs pressure for 1 to 1.5 hours. And after the bags have been sterilized and cooled down to room temperature or say up to 20 degrees centigrade, they are inoculated with wheat grain-based spawn at the rate of 4% dry weight basis. And inoculated bags are incubated at room temperature between 23 to 25 degrees centigrade for mycelial growth. After spawn run, it will take 15 to 20 days for spawn running. And after spawn run, keep bags in a dark at a temperature of 10 to 14 degrees centigrade and maintain the RH at 80 to 85%. This RH requirement is similar for all the mushrooms, that is 80 to 85%. And after giving these conditions, the primordia will form in 10 to 12 days after reducing the temperature, and fruit bodies of 14 to 18 centimeter long will be harvested. And fruit bodies are packed in PP bags and can be sun-dried. This is winter mushroom and Phlemurina species, and also known as golden needle mushroom. Fruit bodies are very small here in this case, and stipe length is more. And stipe length in this case, more stipe length is desirable, and which can be increased by increasing CO2 concentration in the cropping rooms, which will promote this type land to grow more. And can be also cultivated on plastic containers or plastic bottles. And this is the maximum size of this mushroom. If you keep the mature fruit bodies in the cropping room for 3 to 4 days, then this type of mushroom will be observed. And presently, a lot of people are cultivating this mushroom, that is Cordyceps militaris, as it is a highly prized mushroom and medicinal mushroom. And lot of people had started cultivation of this mushroom because of its cost. It is highly, they are selling it at the rate of 1.5 to 2 lakhs rupees per kg. And here at DMR, we are also imparting training of this mushroom. And for cultivation of this mushroom, same equipments are needed, that is autoclave, laminar, air probe, BOD incubator, some shaker, and plastic or this glass jars. And in a room of 10 into 10, room size of 10 into 10, one can accommodate almost around about 1000 jars of 500 ml capacity. And see, here you can see the good fruit bodies of this Cordyceps militaris is coming on the artificial media. Here we are using artificial media. No, it grows not on this wheat straw or sawdust, but we have to grow it on this brown rice medium using some supplements and giving some perfect condition and alteration in temperature, so that after 30 to 35 days you can get the first harvest of this Cordyceps militaris. Here I am not disclosing the cultivation technology of this mushroom, but if somebody wants to undertake cultivation technology of this mushroom, one can write to our director, or if time permits, they can visit Directorate of Mushroom Research for undergoing practical training on the cultivation of this mushroom. Thank you very much.